Hey everybody, Shug here. I'm going to kind of go over this Tee-Dee's method of using the ridge line above the hammock here today. Try to show that going up, coming down, and see if it makes a little bit more sense for everybody. I got to see if it makes sense to me. All right, a little more detail on this connection. Prussic knot, shock cord, ridge line. Here I have an S-beaner, and this is the end of my tarp. So I simply loosen up the prussic knot and unhook my tarp. The prussic knot slides on the cord and it holds tight when it's down. So you can adjust things. Everybody foot loose, cut loose, put on your Sunday shoes. Now let's show how this tarp gets hooked up to here. Try to keep up, it's pretty complicated. Take your S-beaner, hook it to the prussic, pull it back, and your tarp is tight. Or tighten your ridge line. Nice look inside the tarp. A little different setup for the doors this time. And also the ridge line makes a handy place to tie your door up right up to your ridge line. And I've just got a little, I just have a little knot in there that I can pull loose. Our mighty, let's try rigging it like a mainsail or a jib. Well, this setup here just gives you a little different option. So why would we even hang our tarp like this? You can see right here, my hammock is poking out, and my tarp is not covering evenly. Adjust my tarp along my hammock easily. That seems to be about the main reason to me. It's just another tarp hanging option. Whether you just go off the ridge lines like I've always done in the past or use TD's option, I'll definitely take it out on a trip and try it, because that's where I'll really find out its advantages. Okay, I've talked to you a while without blinking my eyes, and that's always weird. Yeah. I'm kinda hunched over. Blink your eyes, dude.